Hey Libra, welcome back to my channel everyone. Thank you for tuning in, my lovelies. I do hope this reading is going to be helpful for you. I'm going to be doing a love reading, your next big love, and we'll see who's coming up for you romantically. So this absolutely can be for Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. And I'm so excited to see who is coming up for my Librans watching. Can we learn about this person? Wow, okay, definite soulmate coming in. How amazing is this? Beautiful destined pairing. I'm really getting a strong Gemini from this sign with the Lovers card here, but I feel like divine fate, the universe, God is bringing the both of you together. This is a beautiful card. It's one of my favorite cards. I think it's a great card for manifesting love here as well. So I'm getting, you've been manifesting a dream person or a particular kind of person in your life, Libra. And I feel like the universe is listening and giving you things that match what you're putting out there, which is absolutely beautiful. It's straight away, I'm getting a face-to-face meeting. And a very particular conversation between the both of you when you connect. Okay, could also have Pisces in their chart. Gemini being reinforced with the Six of Cups. That's twice. Okay, strong Gem. Or someone who's a Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, possibly Pisces, or you're meeting in the time of Gemini or Pisces. Could be this or next year. Okay, interesting situation here with the Three of Swords and the Three of Pentacles. Okay, for a lot of you Librans watching, you are paired up with someone and then you're going to meet this next big love. But a lot of you might be in a relationship where it's comfortable, okay? What am I saying? I'm seeing a complacent relationship here for some of you watching. So if this is you, hear me out. You've gotten comfortable in a certain situation with a certain person, but the love has gone, the love has faded, or there's been some sort of transgression here. There's been times where you've been thinking about ending this relationship, and some of you are in the process of ending it or are almost thinking about ending a situation. You do have an ending coming up because you do have a new beginning coming. The number three is very powerful. It's come up here several times. The reason is because you're wrapping up a chapter in your life and this next big love is connected to a new chapter. So it might be leaving one relationship for the next. A lot of you, I wouldn't recommend having both of these relationships. Again, it's not a good energy to start a connection with, okay? I'm never a fan of it, this whole deception and cheating. I never really support it. I know the heart wants what it wants, but if you want the best kind of energy and best foundation with this person, it would be good to wrap things up before entering into something new. So, look, I'm not judging. You do what you want. You do what makes you happy. But I'm just really fighting for energy because I think when you come into something fresh, loyal, committed, curious, and giving, you can literally give all of yourself, right? When you're sharing your energy, yourself between two different people, it's so hard to do that. And none of them are getting the best version of you because your energy is cut in half and it's hard. It's hard to give from a cup that isn't full, okay? That's my rant. But, okay, so third party situation, there's a lover's triangle. For some of you, I'm getting it's a childhood friend or someone you built a friendship with or someone you've sort of friend zoned. They wanna come out, they might make a confession with this next big love and I think it's gonna be really big and flashy. But I feel it's someone you're introduced to through a friend or someone you meet face to face. You might meet in your hometown. It's kind of like a wholesome environment that you're meeting in. So I'm not getting a real superficial environment. I'm getting wholesome is coming to me. So could be going down the coast, could be visiting an old town, could be visiting the old neighborhood. Yeah, something wholesome. But there's a sweetness to this. So I'm getting this as a very sweet person. But they might be oblivious to the fact that you're taken or that you have someone else next to you. So I'm getting at someone who doesn't really know too much about you. But for some of you, for a lot of you, actually, this person's already in your life. You know each other. You've met, you've crossed paths in some capacity. And how exciting to think. It's like, guess who? But there's a prophecy you have to fulfill with this person. So they're not here by mistake. You've got the number two here. This is a very strong relationship number, okay? Two energies, two parties, two entities coming together to form one. So there's also fertility here. Could be someone that works with pregnant pregnant women, pregnancy, children. It's a very feminine energy with this, actually. So they could work with females, a lot of feminine products, maybe very pampered, very feminine. It's almost like they could work in like beautifying something. Okay. It could be like makeup artist. It could be someone that's like a designer. It could be someone that works with like high end. I just feel like there's a lot of beauty, something about beauty, but more feminine beauty is coming up. Maybe they're working like a designing clothing or something with like very feminine, frilly kind of stuff. I don't know if that's making sense, but that is what they're coming up with. They're in a creative role. Okay, so it could be like a creative director, could be like a creative designer, could be like a website creator. Something about creation is coming up around this person. They're very bright, they're full of ideas, they can juggle a lot of things at the one time. Again, would sort of be reflective of Gemini in their chart. They're a great multitasker, several jobs, several projects at the one time, could even be studying several different things. It's like they have their finger in every pie, okay? That's what's coming to me. They're a very well-dressed person. They present themselves very well. Look at this. And I'm also getting art next to this person. Something about art. They might do drawings. They might go to an art class. They might love contemporary, modern, classical, Renaissance art. Something about this. It's very particular though. They have a particular, very niche taste in something is what I'm getting. Or it's like they've been raised in a family or an environment that appreciates art. I think they have a very close friendship circle. There could be one of three children, or there's two other people in their friendship circle, which would make three. It could also have like three big projects. They could have children, okay, a set of twins, or maybe three children individually. As well. But I feel like they're a bit of a jack in the box, which the Geminis normally are. So I feel like anything they sort of turn their hand to, they do it well. I'm getting that they're well coordinated. I'm getting that they're quite active, quite sporty. I'm also getting that they're quite protective. There's a very strong protective side to this person. I'm also getting that there's something that's something that happened in their life that made them stronger, or they're very strong-minded because of this. Could be like an incident, an accident, a loss, a traumatic event, something that has shaped and molded them into the person that they are now, which is a very strong person. I'm getting it. They're very supportive, and they're going to be very supportive of the things that you do. They're always going to be in your corner, and they'll be happy to help. So you'll work well together. It's almost like working like a team. There is a love for children, and they may want more children. You or them could already have a couple of kids, and there might be another one. Okay, divine conception. The pomegranate fruit is pregnancy. We've got children here. Okay, the seeds of creation. So if you want more children, this person might be able to give you a bigger family, this love, this connection. I think this is really good. I think you're going to have a very playful relationship with this person. I'm getting playful. I'm getting marriage. I'm getting a relocation. But you're relocating to a more wholesome area. Okay, it could be a country town, could be a ranch, it could be a little cottage. You're going to live a more quiet life with this person, but it's going to bring you peace. Trust me, it's going to bring you peace. And yeah, look, I think it's going to go really, really well. But I'm going to leave it there. So I do hope that has been helpful, Libra. Thank you again for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to see more. That would be absolutely appreciated. And hopefully we'll be in touch again very soon. So thanks again, everyone, and bye for now.